going to talk about procedural graphics and audio. It's like we're going to talk about how to use mathematics and implement it in algorithms to present graphics and to make the computer make sounds and create effects for us. So, hello. This concludes my slideshow. Yeah, I'm serious. So this... Yeah, I'm sorry about the flash. I tried to learn C++ OpenGL and make it in a hurry today, 12:30 o'clock, so I didn't have time, so I defaulted back to my original language. It's really fast. It's a lovely language. You can still use it to make throw off implementations. It's okay. So our first demo here, let me walk you through the overview of our presentation. I'm gonna build up a small demo prototype of a graphical demo. Okay, so our first component of this formula is this little two sticks. They follow our pointer. But they do something interesting when once you come in close. Well, how it's doing that, it's really high school mathematics. We have here, it's like my pointer is here. So it's if it's far away, it knows where it needs to point out and it can't extend beyond that point. Okay, so when I come closer into my joints, like my arm, it will do a simple mathematical equation to find out this little right triangle and use Pythagoras' theorem to find the angle and use that angle to find the other angle that will make it end up at the point I'm pointing at. Okay, it's very simple. I'm not gonna get into all the code because I know you're all tired after about 9 talks maybe. So we created first an arm, a wing, whatever. So, but I was moving it myself. So how can I move it automatically? If you notice over here, all I'm doing is moving that arm in a circle. And I flipped it around, and it's a bird or whatever you can imagine. Okay. So we have a bird. What should we imagine next? It's a plane's worst nightmare. A flock of birds. Okay, so how the previous stuff is really simple. This is simple too, but the principle behind this is different from the ones before it. Don't look at all the stuff together. Look at each one as a block. What am I doing? There's nothing 3D, real 3D here. I'm simulating 3D using a simple formula. I have a Z axis. It's like, it's over here, it's 1. It's over there, it's 10. Based on this number, I'm scaling back, scaling smaller each bird and making it a little bit dimmer to make it appear as if it's coming into my face. Okay. Okay, so this concludes part one of my presentation. The other part is about audio. We talked about graphics and creating stuff, building it over it step by step, using simple blocks to create larger blocks, and making it into a complete showcase, for example. في خمسة. I need to set back stuff a little bit.
This is why we love live demos at
the peaks. Yeah, it's just a simple function replacement, but. Okay, so everybody loves to play MP3s and so on, but almost most of the population don't know how audio is really built into and outputted out of speakers. So here we're gonna have a little foray into the world of dark sounds. Our first function, the number one signal analysis thing everybody learns, is how to create sound out of a sine wave. The simplest sound we hear is a sine wave. So here, Flash has a courtesy of allowing you to feed it samples of a signal, and here we're just trying to feed it a simple sine wave. So this is what a sine wave sounds like. Everybody here. So sine wave is really simple. So how can we create, like we did with a bird, with a wing, with a bird, with a flock, we're gonna try to play this game on sine waves. So the next step is to combine two sine waves in a really simple way. We have a sine wave, I'm gonna allow to be heard, then not allow to be heard, using another sine wave that's really much slower than the first. The first sine wave is gonna be like shh. The next sine wave is like gonna be really slow, really clean, really big. It's like waves compared to small audible sounds. I call this function amplitude modulation because that's here we're hearing it like happening, not happening, happening, not happening. So in what other ways can we play on sounds and make it create different patterns? We have a single sine wave, it's gonna sound the same, different amplitudes, we're gonna hear it and not hear it. So how can we combine two sine waves to create different sounds at different times? We can feed a sine wave to another sine wave. I call it sine-sine. Then it gets fucked up because, well, I really don't know why it gets fucked up. So I tried to rethink it. Okay, what's gonna happen? So I tried to rethink it, and the solution to why it gets out of control. I don't want it to start building up frequency on and on. I just fed a sine wave to another sine wave, and it got out of control. So the key to the solution of this problem is to change the phase of the sine wave. Perhaps you're not gonna get exactly what this means, but if you're gonna try it, maybe you can search for these keywords. This is different from amplitude modulation because pitch is different, changing between every instant and instant. When I'm a class
nice.
Shanda. هيدا بدا من عندي انا هيدا اخر فانكشن عملت لك ابل بيس من عندك يا سام يعني ما كان ممكن تكون احسن من We're gonna conclude with randomized. It's really simple and it's really not interesting, but I'm gonna. What's happening here is we have a single sine wave, but we're not advancing the phase each time exactly the same. We're advancing it at a random, but with an average amount. And that's it.